Let me thank everybody who has come here from distant areas to express solidarity with the people of Kashmir. As we all know, ladies and gentlemen, that Kashmir is known as the paradise on the surface of earth. But today, when I am talking to you, that paradise does not exist anymore. That paradise has become the killing fields. That paradise has become the hellfire for the people of Kashmir. Ladies and gentlemen, today Kashmir has lost its magic. Today Kashmir has lost its beauty. Today Kashmir is known as the most beautiful prison on earth. Unfortunately, today there is only one thing in Kashmir. That is suffering and suffering and nothing else but the suffering of the people of Kashmir. Ladies and gentlemen, the presence of 700,000 Indian military and paramilitary forces has made Kashmir the largest army concentration anywhere in the world. It was none other than President Bill Clinton who said that Kashmir was the most dangerous place on earth. But unfortunately today, not only the United Nations, but even the United States of America, they have not broken their silence. They have not uttered a single word to condemn the humorous atrocities in Kashmir. The people of Kashmir would like to ask, what happened to your high moral ground? What happened to your democratic values? What happened to your human rights? What happened to your universal principles? The people of Kashmir are asking to the United States of America, are you going to sacrifice the universal principles for the business deal? Are you going to sacrifice the American values for the commercial investments? The 18 million people of Kashmir, they appeal to President Barack Obama, don't listen to anyone, but listen to your own conscience. It was you, President Obama, who said on October 30th, 2008, inspiring words. The inspiring words which has given the hope and optimism not only to the people of Kashmir, it has given the hope and optimism to 1.5 billion people of South Asia. Those inspiring words of President Barack Obama, that he would facilitate an understanding between India and Pakistan to help Kashmir, to help resolve Kashmir crisis. We would like to tell President Barack Obama, we know that you are under a lot of compulsions, but we also know that you are a man of peace. We also know that you are a man of principle. It is because of their two beautiful qualities, President Barack Obama. We would like to urge you to persuade government of India to end the genocide in Kashmir. We would like to urge you to persuade both India and Pakistan to initiate the peace process with the leadership of the people of Kashmir. Because you know it much more than anyone else. If the Kashmir issue is resolved, it is going to bring peace and stability in Kashmir. But more importantly, it is going to bring peace and prosperity to India, to Pakistan, to Afghanistan, 1.5 billion people of South Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming over here to express your solidarity with the oppressed people of Kashmir. They know, honest to God, they know, although we are not able even to talk to them today. There are no telephone services. There is no internet. But they know that there are people who are the ambassadors of the message of Kashmir. They do not need to be only Kashmiri Americans. We have the Indian Americans who are here. We have the non-Muslim Americans who are here. Kashmir is a basic humanist issue. Because when we are talking about the issue of Kashmir, we would like to make it clear. The decision has to be taken not by New Delhi. The decision has to be taken not by Islamabad. The decision has to be taken by the people of Kashmir, whether they are from Azad Kashmir, whether they are from Indian occupied Kashmir, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims. The decision has to be taken by 18 million people of Kashmir from both sides of ceasefire line. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, dear brothers and sisters. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless your families. May Allah bless the people of Kashmir. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.